from Bengaluru. And today we're asking the question, who killed Gauri Lankesh and why? Why was this outspoken journalist gunned down outside her home? Was it because there were some who didn't agree with her ideology? Have we really become a society where murder and violence is resorted to if we don't agree with somebody's ideas? Joining us here to discuss this in Bengaluru, people from both sides of the political spectrum and those in between as well. Now, what has been noticed from the time the news of Gauri's death spread, there was an assumption. We had Rahul Gandhi tweeting also that it was the RSS who was behind it. It was right-wing extremists who were behind this. As a member of the RSS, Mr. Rajesh, as a spokesperson of the RSS, how do you respond to something like that?
RSS has severely condemned the murder of Gauri Lankesh, what happened, and we express deep condolences as well. And we extremely condemning all such killings of the social workers in Karnataka and elsewhere also. In recent past in Karnataka, more than 30 different social workers, including from RSS, 12 of them from RSS, were killed and murdered and because of the ideological issues. So we already requested the state government to inquire into these murder issues, especially the recent murder of Gauri Lankesh as well. Before even M.M. Kalburgi murder also, we requested a quick impartial, not just this murder, including RSS murders and all social activists' murder. But the state government is reluctant.
Brijesh Kalapa, Congress spokesperson, that is exactly what Ravi Shankar Prasad has actually said. He has said that the law and order is a state issue and that Gauri should have been provided security. And there has been objection to Rahul Gandhi's tweets blaming the RSS.
I think the first point that ought to be made is that although Gauri Lankesh knew our chief minister extremely well and used to meet him from time to time, she never happened to mention that, look, I needed security, right? So to that extent, I think unless a person says, look, I'm facing threats, it's impossible to provide security to all 6 crore Kannadigas. So I think that's one part of it. The second aspect is that as far as there are 4 murders now, Pansare, Dabolkar, Kalburgi, and Gauri Lankesh, right? Now, what are the similarities in their murders? All of them were trenchant critics of the right wing, that's of the RSS. The second is that they've been consistently speaking about this. The modus operandi of the murders is almost similar. Friendly entry, somebody comes, shoots and leaves, right? Then the third aspect is that there are trolls, right? Right-wing trolls. They celebrate. It's a jubilation. It's a triumphant situation for the trolls who belong to the right wing exclusively, right? So this pattern is there in all 4 murders. It can't be just a coincidence. It just can't be that one case is taken and then you say that, look, this is only Gauri Lankesh's case. It's exactly the same way. Even at the death of Anantamurthy, yes. You are Anantamurthy. People are celebrating the deaths and all of them belong to one political ideology. So what do you say to this? Do you say that, no, you absolve them? No, because there is no the smoking gun.
These were all people who spoke against Hindutva, who spoke against the right wing. Vivek Reddy, BJP spokesperson and senior advocate. The people who were killed belonged left of center. They were anti-Hindutva. They were critical of the right-wing ideologies. And so behind the killing, is it the right wing as people would...
I just heard what Brijesh said. And one thing, the point which Mr. Rajesh Padma made out is very clear. Do we have the facts today regarding the reasons for the murder? We don't have the facts. When we don't have the facts, can Rahul Gandhi play the super cop? Can he be the Sherlock Holmes who can decide who is responsible for the murder? That is not possible. So we will have to wait for the facts to play out and find out who is behind this murder. Now, on the basis of patterns, there were tweets with various Naxals also. So there could be various dimensions to this. And his brother, Indrajit, said that all dimensions have to be probed and I wish the state government can have an impartial probe. Now, what Brijesh says that there have been various trolls and there has been a pattern. Can that be a decider? Are we not, as members of civil society, as people who are waiting for the law to play out, are we not bound by the truth? Whoever has done it, it is a condemnable act. He has to go inside.
There is no question about that. There is absolutely no question about that.
So therefore, one more thing is, there is no question of saying that there have been trolls and there have been... therefore, we link it to that. It has the same pattern. Trolls are different. This is people reacting in the marketplace. they will react in various ways.
What I would like to say is, it's very obvious with the tweets, the last tweets by Gauri, she said, we should not fight among ourselves. Our enemy is different. Let's stay together. Let's stay together and fight it out. That's what she said. That means there was two split groups in her own party, probably the Naxals. Her brother very clearly said, there are a lot of hate letters and hate messages saying that you should not make us come to the main street. We stay where we are. And even the pamphlets were distributed in the Western Guards saying that no Naxalite would like to go to the mainstream because no, they are not proper at all. Let them not bring into the world of dirty world of the political party that is ruling the state. That's what the pamphlet said. And taking into all this consideration, I feel it is being unnecessarily being politicized and fingers pointed. As Padma said, the onus lies in the government to bring down the books, the people who are responsible for it. They have been failing time and again, right from Kalburgi, Pansar and Dabolkar, everything. They're bad at work. And today, there is no absolutely safety for anyone, leave alone the activists. Or even people like the politicians like us, there's no safety there.
Prithvi Reddy of Aam Aadmi Party. The idea, even Kavita, Gauri's sister, saying that she thinks it may be the right wing behind it because of Gauri's views. We've had the Maoist angle surfacing. We've had perhaps the slight deviation towards it's a duty of the state to provide security. Your response to all this, who would you say is really behind the murder? Was she killed for her ideology?
Let's be very honest. Until the investigations are completed, there's no way of knowing who exactly committed the murder. However, let's understand that Gauri's murder was symptomatic. It was a symptom, it was not the disease. The disease is what is happening in this country for the past 3 years, a spread of hate, a spread of unnecessarily attacking and condemning certain ideologies, which did not happen earlier. Now, I would like to point out that earlier this year, during the celebrations of Mr. Lankesh's birth anniversary in Davangere, the ABVP attacked Master Yogesh on stage. When an elderly, well-renowned writer like U.R. Anantmurthy, in his last days, the BJP and the RSS were issuing death threats. And it was nice of some of the BJP people to come forward and condemn it.
Yes.
But what is happening is you are spreading hate. And that's why I said it on an earlier show that I believe that this is not an incident of hate. This is not a hate killing. This is not a violent incident. This is an attempt to terrorize people. It has to be treated as an act of terrorism.
Act of terrorism.
Nothing short of that.
It was not a hot-blooded thing.
The intent of whoever is behind this is to spread fear and terrorize people. There's absolutely no taking away from that. Let investigation reveal.